Okay, here is the Frosty machines, and we are going to solve this problem together. And we found from this objective function there are quite a few variables: 1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4, and it reflects this diagram, network diagram. And I'm going to put x1, 3, 1, 4, 2, 3, 2, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6, and so forth here, and coefficient there. And that's my objective function. And the objective function is entered in the Excel function. And we have constraints. We have 7 constraints, so 2 supply constraint, 3 demand constraints, and 2 supply and demand has to be equal. Those laws are entered in here. And I carefully enter the signs, equal sign over here, according to this formulae constraints. And the right-hand side is entered, and some product function was used, and I again fixed the variables from L4 to U4 because I have to copy it down for that absolute reference it was used. One thing that I want to bring your attention to is this one: x13 plus 23 equals x35 plus x36 plus x37. So I move this right side to the left side, so it becomes right side, hand side becomes 0. And then if you subtract x35, 36, 37 here, it becomes 0. And x13 plus x23 minus 35 minus x36 and minus x37 is given right here, right? So rather than putting that on the right hand side, I subtract that and made it 0. And then on the left side, I have negative signs for them. Similarly, shipping at follow, I have this function, and I subtracted them and then subtracted on the left side, and I have negative sign for them. So then I express this condition, supply equals demand condition here. And we are ready to run our Excel solver, and they will produce the result. So I have L7 there, and then L4 to U4, that's good. And V12 over here, it should be U12. So something is not right. Oh, it's V12, right? V12. V11. So somehow, let me add, or let me change V12. Is this V12? Okay, this is V12. So I was worried if it's not V12. Okay, V12, X12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So it looks good. Simplex method. And check on non-negativity function a constraint, and then solve. So you solved, and I have this result. So x1 13 is 650 and 4 150. So I see that 1 to Chicago, so Toronto Chicago about 650 shipment. So mostly Chicago, from Toronto to Chicago, it makes sense, right? From Detroit to Chicago, I'm sorry, Buffalo, I'm sorry, Toronto to Buffalo is minimized at 150. It makes sense, right? Because they are far apart. Now Detroit to Chicago should be 0, but Detroit to Buffalo should be 300 because it's nearer than Chicago. So that was the decision made. And 3 to 5 is 0. Chicago to New York, it should be 0. Chicago to Philadelphia is 350 according to this calculation. And 3 to St. Louis is 450. And Buffalo to New York, 450. And Buffalo to Philadelphia should be 0. It shouldn't be covered by Buffalo, but by Chicago, interestingly. and X47 is centralized because I think it's all because of the transportation cost associated with it. And that's what we found here. And if you go to sensitivity analysis, then we can see that there's a shadow price for supply. It's a zero, so it's very tight and binding constraints. And we see demand. If demand increases in New York, that might increase $9 of total cost. And Philadelphia the same. So overall, demand is going to increase cost. That's no brainer. And the cost difference is quite low, so it's not making much difference. Now, shipping Chicago and Buffalo and cost and I mean supply and demand should be equal. That is given here. And if it does not have to be equal, then it increase $4 or $7 for that. In other words, you have more supplies than demand, then it will increase your cost by $4 or $7, right? So that's what it shows here in this sensitivity analysis, and that's for trans-assignment problem.